We're joining the International Space Station Flight Control Room, the control team, in the Space Station Flight Control Room here at the Mission Control Center in Houston. The Orbit 2 team is on console at this time, and they're led again today by Flight Director Paul Dye. He's joined today with, by Anna Fisher in the Capcom seat. On board the International Space Station, the Expedition 31 crew has been awake since 1 a.m. Central Time, despite being up a bit late last night, staying up to photograph the historic Venus transit, a photo of what that looked like here. Commander Oleg Kononenko and U.S. flight engineers Don Pettit and Joe Akava, as well as European flight engineer Andrei Kuipers and Russian flight engineers Gennady Padaka and Sergei Revin, are now more than halfway through their day. Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit have been at the space station since December, and they launched into space on December 21st, docking on the 23rd. Now, with 168 days in space and 166 at the space station, they're coming up on the end of their mission, scheduled to return to Earth on July 1st. Their crewmates, Akaba, Padaka, and Revin, still have most of their mission in front of them. They only launched from Baikonur on May 14th and arrived at the station on May 16th, which means they've now spent 22 days in space and 20 at the space station. A couple of weeks after their crewmates leave, Akaba, Padaka, and Revin are going to be joined by what will then be the rest of the Expedition 32 crew, Sonny Williams, Yuri Malenchenko, and Aki Hoshide. Those three are scheduled to launch from Baikonur on July 15th, and they're already in Russia preparing for their departure. Today they were at the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center in Star City, taking part in a Russian segment simulation. In space, the day's work has focused on maintenance and crew health monitoring experiments. Don Pettit has been spending a good deal of his time this morning preparing for repair work that he'll be doing tomorrow on the amine swing bed experiment. That experiment is working to determine whether a vacuum regenerated amine system can effectively remove carbon dioxide from the space station's air. But its control and power control unit power handler circuit board has blown a fuse that Pettit's going to be replacing tomorrow. This week's work with the Ryutei experiment rack is also continuing. Pettit and Kuipers have been taking turns working to replace a short-circuited power supply in its image processing unit. Pettit did the actual repair yesterday, and today Kuipers is reinstalling the repaired unit into the experiment rack. Joe Akaba is also doing another round of monitoring for the integrated cardiovascular experiment, which looks at how the body's cardiovascular system reacts to being in space. And he's in the middle of a session of the Pro-K diet experiment as well, which is an experiment to see if dietary countermeasures will help lessen the bone loss that astronauts often experience during long-duration missions. And finally, on the Russian side of the space station, the cosmonauts were also participating in several space science experiments. Gennady Padaka was again today scheduled to work on the Kolonovsky crystal experiment, which studies the effect of microgravity on charged particles and a magnetic field, as well as the bar experiment, which looks at different methods of detecting leaks on the space station. He's also got some time set aside to work on an experiment that monitors group activities under spaceflight conditions. That's what's going on in space today, and this is Mission Control Houston.